converting a triple chainring MTB to a single narrow wide chainring, getting rid of the front derailleur along the way. I need to rotate the quick release link, now on the top, around to the bottom through the recently installed first component's pulley wheels. This makes opening the quick release link easier due to more convenient tool access. I'll open the link and remove each side from each end of the chain, then remove the chain. A 10mm Allen wrench to loosen the crank bolt. Now for the pinch bolts. And that's the triple removed. The first step in removing the front derailleur system is release the cable bolt. Off with the cable cap. Now for the derailleur clamp. So much for the old setup, now for the new. With the derailleur cable clear, I can work on removing the shifter. That means removing the grip first of all, then moving the brake lever out of the way. Then, off with the shifter and back on with the brake lever and grip. I'll fine-tune and tighten the bolts later. But now for the new crank sporting the narrow wide chainring. A smear of grease for the new crank bolt. Around 1.5 Nm is tight enough. I'll give the pinch bolts a preliminary tighten before grabbing the torque wrench. Locking in 13 Nm. I'll tighten each bolt in turn, bit by bit, until reaching tolerance. Sliding the brake lever flush with the grip. A 3mm Allen wrench for the fork lock lever. And a 5mm wrench for the brake lever. Finishing off by tightening the grip bolts. And replacing the bar end plug. Now to get the drivetrain working. I'll firstly feed one end of the chain into the derailleur cage, making sure it goes over the bridge. Pull it almost all the way through, then feed the other end around the top pulley and onto the cassette. and then over onto the new narrow wide chainring. The new narrow wide crank is installed and working smoothly. If you found this video useful in some way, give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button while you're at it. Thanks for watching!